Hello, everybody, and welcome back to the Editor's Hour. My name is Nick Landro, the Editor-in-Chief of The Escapist, joined by Casey Wosu.
And what's today, up, y'all?
We are playing Hell Let Loose, which is a realistic World War II FPS. Just fair warning, this game can be extremely slow, but when things happen, I will squeal and scream, and you will know that I am close to death. If you're curious about what this game is, as I said, it's a realistic World War II game, but it's not like Postscriptum or Squad where it's like super, super realistic. It's got like the mechanics of those games, but it's a lot more about like squad team-based play on these huge maps with a giant front line that you're kind of taking and pushing forward and pulling back from on the other team. It's kind of the gist of it. I mean, it's not too super complex. It's just more like, you know, a large part of the game is kind of strategizing with your team, and each team has a commander, and basically that commander will relay objectives to your squad leaders. So every game has like a bunch of different squads with squad leaders. Those squad leaders relay to you, the member of the squad, and then you're off going off and doing your own objectives within the game. So it's actually really cool. It's not like Battlefield where we were playing that for game night the other night. You're just running around the map kind of looking for things to do. In this, you have to pay attention and do what you're told if you want to win. It's that
strategy. How do they handle those instructions? Because Battlefield was kind of like you get like a message on the screen, and that was and like a marker. Do you actually have to be in voice chat for this today?
You're supposed to. I can probably manage without and just follow my squad. But yeah, typically you would definitely want to be using voice chat. Holy shit! I had no idea this game was that popular now. I mean, these full servers here. Let's see.
Mpoxen, thank you so much for your continued subscriptions. That they've subscribed for 9 months now. This feels way longer than that. I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. And VidKid as well for your renewed subscription. 21 months on a 21-month streak. It says mine feels shorter.
Like Rising Storm. Yeah, I would say this is even more strategic than that. Oh man, they have servers now where you can't play without voice.
Oh dang.
I don't want to play Hong Kong server, Russian server. Let's see.
Well, I don't know. It's too risky probably to like let rando voices out on the stream. But I am curious how people who play this game on a regular basis sound in voice chat.
Like it's been really friendly. Like I've never, as much as I've played it, I've never dealt with some, and this is the honest truth, I have never dealt with like somebody just screaming bullshit racist stuff or anything like that, which was obviously surprising. But I
mean, just like, are they like in, like are they role playing at all? Like,
oh yeah,
sound like actual.
Yeah, that's why. I mean, there's some guys that do that, but it's been really extremely friendly. And like, if you just go into a game and say, "Hey, like I'm just learning. If you can help me learn the ropes, you know, they're super nice about it."
Time Sauce says Casey is not playing. No, I am not.
He wanted to learn today.
Yeah. and I see
Evil Squad.
Honey Money saying I might be a smidge lower. I just moved my mic slightly closer to my mouth, so maybe that will help.
Okay, so this is the battle map, right? So the red is the enemy team encroaching on blue. And basically each place you take, so there's like town center here that you have to take. And once you take that, then the battle map moves forward and you can start moving towards the ruins. And basically how it works is you, like, your team has to set up these mobile spawn points, basically, to keep pushing forward, and the other enemy team can come and destroy those.
Okay, so you're on the blue side right now?
Yeah, I'm on the blue side.
So currently at the disadvantage, it looks like.
Oh, yeah. We need to take the next point. So the bad part about this game, I mean, they're fixing it, but the rough part about this game is like the insane amount of hiking you have to do just to get to the front line, and that's why you have to keep your spawn points continuously checked on, because that's how.
Because you did say that the maps are like really huge.
Oh yeah, they're like 18 kilometers. They're huge.
God.
So the green guys are on my squad, and I do have voice chat turned on, so if he does tell me to do something, I can hear it. I'm just not communicating. And then once you do get into combat, like this game is intense. Like there's no indication where bullets are coming from. It takes like
would
one.
Would you define
one or
that
two
as
hits.
Intense?
Yes.
Not knowing where you're getting shot at, bro.
I mean, you usually know it's in front of you, but this is a game like you just have to pay attention. It's a very different game from Call of Duty or Battlefield, where like cover matters. Oh, see, somebody's here.
Are there vehicles in this? Like
yes,
air combat, ground
yes.
combat?
There's not. I don't know if there's air combat yet, but you can call in airstrikes.
Your teammate just get murdered over there?
I'm dead behind me too. I thought I was too afraid to turn around and look behind me.
Yeah, there's no replay either, right? Like, because Battlefield would be like,
nope.
This guy sniped you from over there. Like,
nope, no replay. Yeah, we're losing our other point. This game's probably going to be over soon.
Did you get thrown into a game that was like already in progress?
Oh yeah, yeah, it is. It's all like Battlefield like that. First person, what's that game called? Company of Heroes. Yeah, a little bit. It's kind of like that. Oh, our team doesn't even have a commander. This game's not going to go well.
Lampy's asking important question: are there shotguns and is there team damage?
There is team damage, and like at a certain range. You don't see your own player icons, so you have to like actually choose your shots.
Oh boy.
Yeah.
They're really pushing for that realism thing, huh?
God damn.
But you said the front was like a couple of kilometers out to where you start from, but you're still getting shot at, it seems.
Yeah, I think there's a recon group hiding out over here. I think they're in the trains.
So it seems like they're kind of farming you guys to spawn.
A little bit.
Simon starts this. Now it's clear why Casey's not allowed to play.
Yeah, once this round ends, like we'll get into a game that starts from the start and you can actually see how things work. I'm just trying to get over here now, but I don't think the squad knows exactly what it's doing.
Mpoxen says, I missed it, but how many people in a squad?
Six?
Did we go over that?
Six.
Yeah, I don't think that was stated.
Yeah, and then there's, I think the matches are 32 versus 30, no, 6, 12, 18, 24, 30, 36, I think it might be 50 versus, it's 50 versus 50.
That's yeah, a lot of those servers said like 98 out of something.
Yeah, 100 people, yep. Oh man, they're about to destroy our spawn point.
Andrew Higginbottom says Casey's mic looks like he's advertising some sort of gamer fuel energy drink.
Okay.
Well, that just goes to show like it's a beautiful color. This blue lady came in.
Okay, kill the guy.
Yeah, like there's absolutely no way to know whether that was a friend or foe.
Well, I knew. Oh my god, I knew because of the his attire. You can tell when an American's an American soldier or not.
Because you guys are all wearing gray, from what I can tell.
Yeah, we're German.
Very gray as well.
I have a feeling there's still a squad around here. Yep. And we are pinned down on this spawn point, and they know it's here.
Sir wants to know if I'm still planning to get the Xbox fridge since I got my gamer drink can, Mike.
God damn.
Yes, I really do want that fridge.
The gamer? Oh, the Xbox
yeah,
fridge?
Yeah, the Xbox Series X fridge, yeah. Like, I don't know if you got connections, Nick, when that comes out, but help me out.
Why do you want that?
Because it's dope, like... I don't necessarily need a mini fridge in here, but like just a giant replica of a console.
Gotta join another squad to get out of that. Was not going well for me. I couldn't even get to the front line because they had such a bad garrison spawn. But yeah, I mean, like, so this right here, like, running across a field like this is fucking terrifying. Chances are before I even get across, I'm gonna get hit. Dark Souls of FPS. This game, like, that was a bad first, like, glimpse at this game, because, like, when you're in a squad and people are telling you what to do and you're actually strategizing and making a play, it's an incredible experience. I joined a squad that was just kind of caught in a really bad spawn point.
Yeah, they were getting spawn camped, basically. Andrew Hickman says, this is nicer. The countryside parts look lovely.
Oh yeah, this game's incredible looking. For how big the maps are, like, I haven't played it in a while, so there's a lot of different maps.
Yeah, how long ago were you actually playing this on a regular basis?
Probably about 5 months ago.
Is there anything of note that maybe has changed? Like, do they update this regularly?
Yeah. It's about to go into 1.0 for the first time. It's still in early access as of today, but they've added a ton of new maps. There's escort vehicles, there's tank. I mean, a tank in this game, Battlefield's not very scary when you see a tank. When you see a tank in this game, you better get in cover.
I don't know, it was mostly tanks killing me when we played. Tanks and snipers, that was it.
Yeah, so here you go, we're in a firefight now, no idea where it's at. Took out one. Where's the rest of our squad? I don't know where me and this guy are going. I think we're just... we're going to take out the spawn, one of the enemy spawn points. There's another squad over here assaulting it.
Like the is that the red icon that you guys are heading towards?
Yeah, it was pinged. Yeah, there's no indication that you kill anybody either. So you have to either know that you hit them or check it.
I mean, there's no button to like pretend to fall, right?
you can go prone. That fools people a lot.
Because that's actually pretty fun. Like, play possum real quick, wait for them to run by.
Yeah, I've done that before. Like, artillery hits, and I would just lay down and let them push forward, and hopefully see what happens.
Oh, why'd you shoot that? We didn't have a target on him.
Oh, I hit that guy.
Lampy wants to know if you'll get this on PS5 for the DualSense controller support.
Oh man.
No, this is not a game I would play on console.
Did we both die?
Yep, we both died. Just let it go.
Sword's asking, this game is made by Team 17,
no,
right?
It's published by Team 17. It's made by Blackfoot Studios. Gotcha. And when they were working on this game at the start, there was only 10 of them.
Oh damn. Has that team grown?
Yeah, I don't know about how much, but there's a garrison. All right, let's push forward here.
Andrew Hickenbottom says, if I had the time and patience for online shooters, this would be right up my street. It's slower, tenser, and more simulatory instead of a fast-moving, twitchy death box like Apex, COD, etc.
Yeah, I mean, like, these games aren't exactly easy to get into because, like, you have to be willing to accept that, like, most of the time you're going to die. unless, you know, you have a really good squad that, you know, you communicate with and move forward with. So, like, it took me a long time to get into a game like this, because I've tried a lot of them and I just didn't like them because they were too slow. This game's, like, not overly complex to the point that I don't know what I'm doing. But, yeah, I mean, you have to go into a completely different mindset with this type of game. Like, okay, it's slow. I have to plan strategy. I don't know where my squad is. My entire squad dead. Oh, they're over there. Oh, shit. I got shot at already.
So, you said currently your team does not have a commander.
For some reason, we don't.
Like, because in Battlefield, that can move around if, say, the commander's not doing their job. Like, that's not the case in this. And how do you become a commander? That's what I'm curious about,
just,
too.
You just kind of spawn into it if you want it. Oh, shit. Artillery is terrifying in this game. Oh, stay crouched.
Stay crouched.
Oh, artillery got me that time. I knew I was in trouble. That first one dropped. I was like, that was too close. Okay. Where is my squad? Am I in a squad? Is my squad even
Honey
active?
Money is asking, excuse my noobness, but what is a non-twitchy shooter?
This.
Yeah, I think anything that just doesn't... That's just a slower pace than breakneck. Because that's pretty much what all the other like just highly not, competitive shooters are, right?
Just not like, yeah, not arcadey. Like Call of Duty and all that. Like squad would be non-twitch. This is non-twitchy. I spawned into a very bad spot.
Like I guess anything that's attempting to be simulation or real in any sense would probably be non-twitchy. And you're about asking about Siege and Battlefield 4.
Siege is like a really perfect twitchy. Battlefield 4 is pretty twitch. Siege is right on the cusp of it.
Yeah, there's a lot more tactical thinking and setup and payoff and such. It's not just run around and shoot. Like I think that's the main thing. Like if your goal is to run around and shoot, and that's what you're doing 100% of the time, you got yourself a twitch shooter.
Yeah, I mean, like right now, I have to stay laying down in this grass if I even want to survive this. Because you know, you saw that guy running up. I don't know if I killed him or not. I think we got him.
You do get like a KD ratio or something at the end, right?
Yes.
Or can you check it like mid match?
I don't know if you can check it mid. I think you can check it mid match, but.
Look at this guy's body.
Yep. It's asking for death to check your thing.
I just noticed there's like a black bar on the side of the screen. I don't know if that's your camera box or something else.
Oh, yeah, I'll fix that. As soon as I get blown up by this artillery again.
Mpoggin wants to know, is Chivalry a Twitch slasher? If there ever was one, it's probably Chivalry.
I don't know if it... Yeah, I guess. I think I got that guy.
Well, actually...
No, I did.
If we're going to talk about slashers, like, any of those, like, Platinum-esque, DMC, Bayonetta-style hack-and-slash games, those are a lot more twitchy than Chivalry is...
Yeah, I guess I've never thought about action games that way. I just think they're action games.
And honestly, like the term Twitch is usually reserved for like a competitive thing.
Yeah.
Because you need to react as fast as other humans do.
Yeah. These street battles, man. Like. Imagine this, but like with 40 something other people like across from you just firing everywhere, like you can't see anything. It's
Are they throwing smoke on the other side?
Yeah, we're throwing smoke to push forward. They're just suppressing fire right down the middle of the street.
Oh boy, he can still see me apparently.
Salty says, go, go, go. Never been there, but I immediately know this is Normandy.
Go.
Might be.
Luke McCree says, you mentioned it was a small team effort. What game engine did they use?
This is Unreal Engine. God, that artillery is terrifying. I legitimately get chills hearing that coming because you don't know where it's going. Like, this game's really impressive for how good it is for, I mean, the sound design and everything. Like, I would say it's on the level of Battlefield. Like, pretty darn close for a small indie team. Don't bunch up. You have to. That's the only way you know where people are.
Oh, shit. Yeah, he just ran up there and got shot.
Mandel was asking, are there sticky bombs?
I think so. Oh my goodness.
Andrew Mama wants to know, are all the buildings enterable or only choice / strategic ones?
No, only choice buildings. That's for map design purposes, though. Like, you would never get anything done if all the buildings were open.
Yeah, if there could be, that'd anyone be too intense. In any building.
Yeah. God, that'd be awful. It'd be too real.
It'd be real, though. Yeah, exactly. Like, oh, remember? War's not fun.
Yeah, my squad's not anywhere near each other. I really want to get into
why they're losing so much of the map.
I think we're pushing a bit. We're still holding the same points. I also like how little UI there is in this game. I'm just following this squad that's not my squad.
Because yours would be in green, right? If they were.
Yep. They're not putting down any. Well, I was following three of them, but they all got killed. They're just not putting down a garrison point, which makes it hard to kind of keep together. There's plenty. I mean, it's not like there's any enterable. I mean, there's a lot of enterable buildings in this game, but it's around objective points where they usually are. Yeah, I think I have 3 or 4 kills so far, and this is another one of those games like you're not going to get a lot of kills unless you're on the front line all the time. So if I had to guess, these guys are working. We're working towards point 280 over there. It's taking a minute because we're trying to. I think these guys are trying to get behind one of their garrisons. But yeah, I love the slow pace of this game. It's not too slow like other games. It's just fast enough where like the action is easy enough to get back into where you're not just running the entire match. Because that can happen
a lot
in these games.
There have been like little blips of action since you started up. Like it hasn't been just completely trekking. Though there is a lot of trekking. Like that is.
Yeah, well, that's also because I'm not with my squad because they're not sticking together, so. Hopefully in the next match, when I start fresh, like we'll have an actual commander and, you know, get a squad going. Kind of going lone wolf right this second. I'm actually coming up. I think I'm coming up behind their line, which could go either very poorly for me or very well.
Only time will tell.
Probably shouldn't be running into this artillery, but I'm going to do it. Because there might be people there. Doing like a lone wolf recon thing at the moment.
So does the sound design let you hear like people running around and stuff too?
Yeah.
So there's a good chance they can hear you sprinting at them.
But they won't know that because they sometimes you don't see the icons. I'm definitely coming
it's
up.
It's like a teammate, you think, right?
Yeah. Yeah. Well, when you're firing it down the street at another squad, you're not gonna be looking for it. Yeah, I'm actually, shit, I might be coming up right behind them. I'm definitely walking right into the shitstorm.
Mappy is asking, is there limited ammo?
Yes. Okay, just saw a guy back there.
Oh, Andrew Hickenbottom says, I've seen folks playing it with absolutely nothing on the HUD. You have to use your map, comms, and visuals to ID targets and objectives.
Yep. Oh no, I just had the guy. I got all the way there, right on them, and then I got sniped. Damn it.
Dang. They seem to be well oiled. Like they have someone watching their backs. Because that would have been bad. They were absolutely not looking in your direction.
They probably knew I was there because I was, like I said, I think that squad I was with was heading towards a garrison. All right, so we actually have a garrison now right on the front line. Good. So I can actually do something. Let's see if I can get... Keep my roll. Deploy in 40 and seconds.
Says, games like these always make me worried about cheaters.
There's no... They have pretty good anti-cheat on this, I believe. I haven't dealt with any. Oh, yeah, I need to get that black bar off my screen. One moment. OBS is doing a weird glitch, so let me know. It should be gone. Nope, still not gone.
Andrew Hickenbottom with the £5 donation. Watch out for Tom Hanks. God, that's such a good movie, Saving Private Ryan.
I need to rewatch that again. I have it in 4K, I just haven't rewatched it yet. Okay. That should be fixed now.
Oh, Rachel's in the chat. Says, hi, Nick. Hi, Casey. What's up?
Hello. All right, here we go. With my squad on the front line, things are going to happen now. Or I'm going to blow up my artillery again. Look at that effect for the artillery. That's a seriously impressive smoke effect. I'm not running towards that.
Yeah. Though. That looks really good.
Oh, jeez. I'm glad I got out of that. That was really close.
Yeah, you were running straight at it. Like.
No, the last one was right on me. Okay, can't go that way. Nope.
Lampy says, question, I know Casey is thinking, can you get a bow?
No.
Yeah, probably not too many tactical bows used in the... This is World War II?
I'm dead. Yes, this is World War II.
This is two, right? Yeah.
Oh, I'm dead. No, I'm not. That artillery has us locked in. So for them to even target that artillery, somebody on their team has to be back, like, down that street just mapping us out and calling in the coordinates for the guy holding the artillery at the very back of their spawn. Yeah, that's how cool that is. Like, it's not, you don't just target on the map. Like, you have to call in the coordinates.
That is actually pretty cool.
Boy.
Coordination.
Seen the building? Team, I don't want to die from the artillery. Where are we? Where are we going? Where are we attacking? We have a commander.
You can't just assume control.
I don't want to be the commander. That's a lot of responsibility.
Says, I love Saving Private Ryan. I just find it emotionally exhausting. Yeah, it's sad.
Yeah.
He says, I should rewatch that movie. I pretty much don't remember it at all. I tend not to rewatch many movies, and when I get around to doing it, usually by accident, I realize that I've forgotten most of whatever I knew about that movie. So I should just do that more often. Like, just rewatch stuff that I know that I like.
It's bad.
God, running across streets is the scariest thing in this game. Fields and streets, they terrify me in this game.
Yeah, would not advise. Mike Makes Right says, Mad Jack Churchill killed a German with a longbow during World War II.
Heck yeah.
Is that like in a museum somewhere? How do people know that?
Ooh, I just got a guy right in the head. I just missed another guy.
Maybe says there were longbows during World War II, yes.
No! Oh my god, I got stuck. That sucked. I couldn't get up. I knew he was coming, too.
Dang.
Sad. I made it so far.
Mason Daniel says, and a claymore? Really? In World War II, they were just running around with bows and arrows and swords. I need to see those documentaries.
There's nobody using a mic in this game.
Maybe that's why that team's losing.
This probably is. I mean, like, if you don't coordinate, you're gonna lose these games.
Milky1985 says, watched Hot Fuzz and Robin Hood Men in Tights far too many times. Rewatch my favorite comedies to relax at weekends. The comedies are a little different. Like, I've rewatched, like, Arrested Development, I want to say, like, 3 or 4 times all the way through. Because
yeah, I rewatched, like, How I Met Your Mother and The
show.
Office and Friends,
Yeah,
like, four
stuff like
different
that.
times.
Like, comedies, I can definitely rewatch and rewatch.
We were just getting peppered by somebody with a machine gun down this way.
Oh, Rachel says, my late mother worked in a World War II museum. I'm trying to remember if she ever told me about tactical bows. Oh, she says, correction, a war museum, but World War II was her favorite for which to make exhibits.
Oh my god, there's a guy right next to me. No, you die. Get it. Ow! Damn it! I shot you in the face. How did you kill me? It's not realistic anymore.
Yeah, those bullets had to go somewhere, right?
I hit. Yeah. Well, the first one, you saw the blood hit. I hit him right in the chest.
Old game's broke. There's your cheater right there.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I need to look up this Jack Churchill guy because. And chat says he also killed someone with a sword.
We're gonna try another squad, see how they're doing. Alright, these guys are talking. These guys are talking. And it looks like they are making a flank push to get over here, I believe.
The man double says, I shot you in the face is dangerously close to how wasn't that a headshot?
You saw the blood splatter. Leave me alone.
We would have counted that had we been doing the siege thing, I think.
Yeah, well, count these nuts. You think about that. Okay. I have an automatic rifle now. We're in business. That's another thing. You can't just, like, you have to pick a class with a specific loadout. They heavily balance it, so there can't be, like, the entire game cannot be filled with snipers. There's only 2 recon squads per team.
And only the recon squads can have snipers.
Yes. Which is a really good
thing.
Because
Battlefield didn't do that at all, right? Like,
no.
You could just be anything the
yep.
whole time.
And it works until it doesn't, until everybody's a sniper.
Which Chivalry does. Like, they
Chivalry,
limit how many...
Yeah, they limit how many archers you can have.
Yeah. Would you want to play a chivalry-like game that got this real?
I think there kind of was one, War of the Roses?
Oh, I've not heard of that.
Yeah, it's old. Man, that artillery is just coming down. I hear bullets flying at me, I don't know where they're coming from. I don't know if following this guy's a good idea.
Peter says, I love how realistic the other players look when running around. Not twitchy or video gamey at all. The jumping is a bit goofy, though. That's how I felt when you were playing Battlefield 1. No, Battlefield 5.
5?
Yeah, like the animations for everyone running around look
oh, yeah.
so
they never...
good.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, Battlefield always has really good looking animations. 2042 is probably going to look incredible in that department.
Yeah, I can't imagine they'd go backwards with that.
I think Lamp88 liked me, liked what I said.
They call it a reference to me and my son had it back and forth because he'll say something and I'll say, no, you are whatever that something is.
Yeah.
And on stream, he asked me, like, why do you always say that? And I was like, because it's funny.
Yeah, no you. I like doing that on Twitch troll or Twitter trolls. think I got that guy. Is that a tank in front of us? Oh shit, it is. Nope, not fucking with that. Nope. Getting out of there.
Reet!
Can I build a garrison back here? Nope.
Mandel says, Saving Private Ryan traumatized many vets who went to see it. I guess not many are still around to see this game, but it seems it would do the same.
You know, when I interviewed Hell Let Loose devs once, we talked about that. It's a very specific thing, and I think they said a lot of vets were actually enjoying the game. Oh boy, we're about to lose. Yeah, I don't know. It's, I mean, oh no, it wasn't Hell Let Loose. We talked about that for the Insurgency documentary. Because that one can get pretty realistic. How close is that tank?
Like, I can't imagine, like, the trauma part. And this is me being nitpicky for sure. But the trauma part is probably their experience in the actual war, not the movie that reminds them of it. Like, it's just the movie so realistically, I guess, reminds them of the actual trauma.
Yeah.
I can't imagine those vets were, like, they were perfectly fine, and then the movie was like, oh, that's the last straw.
Ooh, I think I got somebody. I think that's my sixth kill. Probably another one with him, though.
Mando says, yeah, that's what I meant. Okay, just checking.
Oh, I didn't even notice the new foliage physics they added in. Looks really good.
Oh, like the trees blowing in the wind?
Uh-huh.
That does look nice.
Yeah, I mean, this game has a lot of detail for how small of a team made it. I haven't even gotten to play, like, the D-Day map yet or anything like that.
Oh, do you actually, like, come in on the beach
yeah,
and stuff?
Yeah, and it's intense from what I've heard from people that have played it. Because, like, I think games keep trying that, but, like, they never get it right.
Wasn't one of the Medal of Honors, like, really nailed that?
Frontline? Yeah, they took heavy inspiration from Saving Private Ryan.
Yeah, from the movie, right. Yeah, they were basically copying that. Like, I remember playing one of them, and that was in there, and, like, that scene was super intense.
Dang, that guy. Oh, shit. Oh, damn it.
He had the high ground, Nick. Should have gave it up.
They're making a bet on the amount of kills I have.
Ball back. We'll try to take Mount Halle.
All right, I finally just got a command. Oh, they were doing something. He just didn't say anything forever.
Dang.
Oh god, we have no spawn points.
Yeah, red is eating so much map.
Alright, so we're going to attack Mount Halle. And the only place.
Like, is
I
there
can
any
spawn...
advantage to kind of sneaking past the
oh,
enemy
yeah.
and getting deep into their back area?
Absolutely. Yeah, so that was I think I talked about that with Jack on the Escapist show once. So that's like what made me fall in love with this game is like I got into a squad, we were communicating, and basically we got an order from the commander. Where he highlighted on the map, go take out these three garrisons, and basically to do it, you can't get in a fight on the way there. You have to just stealth around the entire enemy encampment back there. And so, like, we went all the way to, like, the edge of the map where we could go. Couldn't get in any firefight, so anytime somebody was running past us, we just had to, like, lay low and lay in the grass and hope they passed. Straight up, like, Saving Private Ryan. We made it all the way back there, took out the encampments, moved the front line forward, and won the match. It was awesome.
Yeah, see that? Yeah, that's
like
I have never
felt more immersed in a game than when we did that. Especially like when we were, the commander was giving our squad leader like continuous updates on where to go based on our recon calls. Like that is cool.
Yeah, that sounds like a fun time.
Yeah, it's if you can get into the pace of this game and you like stuff like that, it's awesome.
Smite Makes Right says the VA has been looking into using war games to help treat PTSD. The idea is that it lets combat vets work through trauma in a safe environment.
What is that called? Immersion therapy?
I think
that's what we were actually. I think we specifically talked about that on the Insurgency doc.
yeah, sort of a face your fears type deal, right? Where you don't have to use anything actually real.
Yeah. All right, so I'm actually, this isn't my squad, but I'm following a squad that's definitely coordinating to get through. Oh man, he just got sniped.
Onion Money says, but is that a rare thing, though, or does that happen all the time?
No, stuff like that. Stuff like that happens all the time in the game. Like, that's how you play the game. Like, you should definitely play it with a group of people that you're willing to talk to and communicate with. Because, like, right now, is what's happening. It's like, we're in the middle of this. We're getting ambushed, actually, is what's happening right now.
So I'm assuming there is team killing, like you're able to shoot
yes.
your teammate by accident.
It's mostly by accident.
But like if they're not giving you any notifications about that stuff, like if you're doing it all,
when you team kill somebody, it will notify you when you team kill somebody.
Okay, all right.
And there's like a forgive thing and everything. Enemy
contact. Because I feel like that'd be a little rough if you really didn't get any feedback that hey, those guys are shooting those are your teammates.
You hear that one? So like in when we play the battle royale games, you know how I'm using the compass to give you callouts.
Yeah.
Gotta do the same thing in here too. So he just called out that there are enemies at 225. So we actually have a garrison up here now, and I think there's an enemy encampment up on that hill up there. Yep. Yeah, I'm not fucking with that. That's too far. So I think the next thing, if these guys seem to know what they're doing, the next thing that's going to happen is we're going to smoke that out and charge across that field.
Likely to take some casualties on the way, I guess.
Oh yeah, you do not make it across the field without casualties. yeah, they're holding that house up there, I think. See, when you get into coordinated stuff like this, it's fun. And it's another game like Siege 2, where like you don't have to be good at shooting. Like if you can be a good spotter and call things out, like that's just as important. Yeah, so like, you know, people calling out where enemies are and everything, so you can grenade it or get a suppression on it or something like that. All important stuff. Boy, somebody has us pinned here.
Lampy wants to know, does the 3MR team have enough coordination to do this for a game night, though?
Doubt it.
I think it's just more patience, right?
I feel like
3 hours on a game night.
Yeah. I mean, if we were going to play this, it'd be like a D&D session where we'd have to, you know, put some time into it. I think Jesse might like this game just because there's more to do than just shoot. Like, you have to plan and think ahead a little bit.
Just make Jesse the commander. Problem solved.
And he'll still find a way to blame me.
Says there's a medic class as well as a radio man.
Yep, trenches are actually useful in this game. Alright, there's that smoke I told you about. That was the next thing they were gonna do. We don't die pushing up.
Charge.
Yeah, we're. Oh man, they just got nailed by artillery. Oh shit! Holy fuck! Look at that effect. That is so cool. They didn't. They didn't die from it. It missed, but oh man.
They tried it though.
But yeah, we're full on assaulting this hill right now.
Amanda says, "No, make Amy the commander. She was such an awesome captain in Sea of Thieves." I second that. Amy was a great captain.
Oh boy.
Got real dangerous. Oh, they're in the building. You see how slow this is, though? Like, how we're just very, very slowly moving up and taking ground back?
Yeah. Like, it's working. Like, yep. A lot of the guys are all still alive and covering all the ground.
Yep. That's coordinated push right there. Like, that's when this game is just incredible. Like, when stuff like this gets pulled up.
Oh my god. Well, so is there a time limit for the match, or is it done when one side beats the other?
There's a time limit. So I haven't looked at the map. We haven't made that whole way we were pushing was up to get Mount Halley's. So that's what that attack was you're watching is taking right. that point. Yeah, Andrew Hickamo says, I love the escalation of this. Yeah, like, you get it slow, you plan out, and then things just hit the fan, and it goes. we took it. That was a big push to take that. And my squad actually has an outpost spawn behind enemy lines up there.
Oh, nice. That should help. That's probably what's thinning the herd for you guys to start pushing back.
No, I don't. They weren't there. I think they were just holding.
Oh, boy, oh, boy. I'm dead. I knew that was going to get me. Artillery.
I didn't think it had us clocked in, but it did. So now we have to take the town center, and that's a hard one to push into. But I mean, that's how hard it is just to take one point in this game.
Now do it six more times.
Yeah, three more times if we can. I don't think we're gonna. I don't even think we're gonna get close to taking it back, but
got to get over that wall. Get over that wall.
Pure Pyro is asking, how newbie friendly is Rainbow Siege?
Jesus.
Newbie? Well, you can't even play unranked or anything until you play like 25 matches of casual or something, right?
Until you reach level 25, right?
I think so.
Which can could take more than 25 matches, depending on how bad you do.
Siege is super newbie friendly. Alright, let's see if they put up another garrison before I run all that way. Because I guess there's a garrison here. I can meet up with them. Does the melee combat have much meaning in this? No. I mean, unless you're going to be right up behind a guy to knife him. No. There's very little opportunity in this game. That's another thing you kind of have to get used to in this game is like very few combat encounters will occur within like 10 meters of you. They are all very long range encounters unless you're running through the middle of a street basically. Like that one guy that ran up on me that I got earlier, like that happens every once in a while. Yeah, those air strafing runs are pretty new, I think. Those have been there, but I don't think they've been that pronounced. Now they're terrifying. they'll scare me more than artillery. I hear those planes coming, I'm like, well, I'm dead.
They look really impressive.
Yeah, because, I was playing Battlefield the other day and telling you, like, how scary the artillery was in that game. This game takes that and amplifies it. You're, like, legit hair raised when you hear that the whistle coming. Because at least, at least in Battlefield 5, when you call our artillery, you know it's coming. Alright, we need smoke.
Andrew Hickenbottom says, would be nice if the melee combat involved some sort of struggle mechanic, like button mash, battle, haha. Like that horrible bit in Private Ryan. Oh, yeah.
What? There was a game that did include that. I think it was...
Ow!
I think it was Call of Duty 3? Alright, we finally lost.
Yeah. Yeah, I don't remember anything like that in any
of the
movies.
Where am I? At the very bottom? Personal stats. And tell me how many kills I did. Oh, there it is. 6 kills, just like I said. 13 deaths. All right, now we can actually do coordinated match. I do want to try Postscriptum, but I really like the pace of this game. And I know from playing Squad, it's a lot shorter. There's also Beyond the Wire, which is the World War One published game from the people that made Squad. We have a code for that. I haven't really played it yet, though, because there was nobody playing it when I started it, but I think it's growing. Whatchamacallit? Squad, though, has, like, the most realistic-sounding weapons I've ever heard in the game.
Squad modern-day combat?
Yeah, Squad's modern. Andrew Jacob says, I'm really enjoying this. I might get it myself, but it looks kind of daunting and all-consuming. It is. I can only usually play like one or two matches in a day because they're so long. They're like an hour long each.
Damn.
I mean, they can go shorter if you just get steamrolled, but...
we just saw, I guess.
Yeah. Are we playing the same match again? I don't know if I want to play the same map. I kind of want to show off a different map.
Yeah, is there a chance we could see that Storming the Beach one?
Yeah. Yeah, this is the same map. I don't want to do this again. Let me out. Gotta keep hydrating. I gotta go to hockey. Oh. Well, got kicked off the host anyway.
Whew. The host went to go play hockey, probably.
Yeah. Hurtgen Forest is really cool. That map is like, so you've played in multiplayer shooters like this, a forest, right? But you've never played a shooting game like this in a forest because it is hard to see anybody. All right, here's Utah Beach. Let's see if I can get into that one. It's fall. Oh, there's Omaha Beach, too. Oh, yeah, I forgot they included multiple of them. I'm really excited to see this game so popular. Like, the devs deserve it. They've done a really good job in early access.
Nice. So 1.0 comes out soon, or just hit 1.0?
Yeah, no, it comes out real soon. They announced it during the Future Game Show. You were watching it with us.
Was I?
Yeah.
the Future Game, yeah. I don't remember how it let loose, though.
I was pretty excited to see it there, but you just ignored me because I'm not cool enough for you, I guess.
I mean, you're probably right.
How rude. There might not be a map yet for me to do that. So I will show you Hurtgen Forest.
Tommy Salty says, these games really are like marriage. They require a lot of commitment, and one mistake can cost you dearly.
Yeah.
Mandela says, so true.
Siege isn't that intimidating.
My wife has been stiff with me because I use some of her milk. Your wife doesn't share milk with you, Mandel?
What? I'm confused.
You guys should go to therapy. Learn to share milk.
Here we go. This match just started, pretty much.
Sora says, get Casey that fridge, Nick, and he will never ignore you again. I don't know. You can't buy my attention. I have standards and all that. Also, have you heard about Xbox Game Pass?
I was gonna say that feels like a specific shot at me for a $50 stream goal I made earlier this month. Okay, look at this map. This map is awesome looking. Once everything loads in.
Man, they've been bombing the shit out of these trees, huh?
Yeah. No, I mean, like, this is like the... I wish more games would have, like, maps like this or, like, realistic forest environments, because it's really fun to fight in, even though it's completely wrecks me.
I like the fire effect on that tree back there.
Yeah. Yeah, this map is terrifying when you start going for points because everybody's brown or gray, and you know, you just gotta look for somebody moving, basically.
And Pocket says this game is on sale on Steam right now, 30% off.
Yeah, I would heartily recommend it. I was recommending it in the community game night server that you guys should play it together. Ooh, I think I just headshot a dude. That the community should get a game night together to play it, because you guys would have a blast, I think. Oh boy, there goes a medic. He almost got ripped apart. There is gore in this game too. You get blown up by a grenade, you definitely know it.
My headset's getting ready to die.
Uh-oh.
I just plugged it in. It's cool. Honey Money says, I don't know. This reminds me of Forest Here.
Forest Here.
Yeah, what happened to your forest, Honey Money?
Definitely remind you if you lived in California.
Oh, shit.
Oh, my. Ooh, well, we smoked the hell out of that. Let's go. Somebody's lobbing bullets at me, and I don't know where from, and I don't like it.
In fact, there was a huge fire 1 mile from my house last year. It was wild. I'm assuming you mean like a forest fire. Yeah, luckily I've never been so close to any fire of that magnitude.
Yeah.
Oh boy, somebody's got my number.
Oh. Hopefully I don't kill Percival. He just ran right through my grenade.
Yeah, it is starting to get into like forest fire season, folks were saying in the chat. Like it was also super hot out today here. And Siphon Dow says it's about to be 110 degrees today where they are.
No thanks. Oh, damn it. They're laying in the trenches. Holy moly. I thought we took it. I was wrong. That's what I get for running in like that. Yeah. I would not want to live anywhere near California these days. Would not want to be terrified for my life every year about forest fires destroying everything.
Yeah, and it's like that's such a hard thing to fight against. Like, hey, look, it's a wall of fire.
Captured the middle point. That's the hardest point to take. And we gotta hopefully push forward. Yeah, that fire effect on the tree is really impressive looking, actually.
Honey Money said, no, you just live in Tornado Alley.
Yeah.
I mean, everywhere has got their,
yeah,
their natural disasters where Mother Nature is trying to wipe off the stain that is humanity. Like, the East Coast has hurricanes. Sandy was a big
main
deal.
Actually, the bright, besides California for the wildfires, the main place you probably don't want to live is like the South right now, because they're like the new tornado. They pretty much are the new Tornado Alley, like the Southeast, Georgia,
yeah,
and all that. Because
yeah,
we don't get a whole lot of. I mean, lately, we haven't gotten a whole lot of tornadoes up here. So, oh, that was a good shot. happy about that one.
Oh, damn, yeah.
Oh, he's got pelted artillery.
I kind of, like, as much as I would like to know that I confirmed a kill, like, just seeing the ragdoll effect when you hit somebody and, like, you just kind of know.
That's what I was wondering, if there was, like a fake a death button and your character just, like, flops to the ground. Because that would be hilarious.
Okay. We have a garrison up here. Thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. I just want to be with my squad.
Insightfully Dev says, there aren't enough forests left on the East Coast to really catch fire, are there? You may have a point. They turned all that into a city.
On the East Coast? All you gotta do is go, like, towards Albany and it's full forest still.
Well, yeah, but, like, who's going towards Albany?
Apparently the rent up there isn't bad.
That's the thing with New York, and I've had this argument back and forth with Will. The only part of that entire state that matters is the city.
Yeah.
Like, you have a whole state that no one cares about. Upstate New York might as well not even exist.
Yeah, it's just New York City and New York.
Right.
Just hand it off to New Jersey. They need the land.
New Jersey's fine where it's at.
Oh, that's right. You live in New Jersey.
The worst part of New Jersey is the part right next to New York. And I'll let you draw whatever conclusion you want about that.
Yeah, I've been there plenty. Unless my family lives in New York. I just like hearing my aunt and uncle say New Jersey. Even though it's a Boston accent.
Yeah, like that New England slash Italian thing, like, yeah. That's what gets called the New Jersey, New York accent. Like, most people don't actually sound like that around here.
I don't know, all the pubs I've been to out there, they sound like that.
I'm with Casey, what about garbage plates? What? What is a garbage plate?
Is that a tank rolling up here? Uh-uh. Better not be. Oh god, it is. Oh god, it's a Sherman. That's scary. Nope, nope. Move. Get me out of here.
Armchair Hero dropping some info. It says, it's been bad and has been getting worse each year. You just didn't hear about it as much. Cali also wastes most of its water on farmers growing almonds, an extremely water-intensive food. And Cali accounts for 80% of worldwide almond sales. Logic is there is none.
Oh!
So they're burning their, or they're risking their forests for that sweet, sweet almond money, sounds like.
Yeah. If you don't know a lot about California, there's actually a surprising amount of farmland up there.
There's farmland in a lot of places you wouldn't think.
Yep.
Like the state of New Jersey, which is probably one of the best places you can get tomatoes, apparently.
Yeah, as soon as you get out of the city, like, Pennsylvania is like farmland the entire way.
Oh yeah, there's hella cows in Pennsylvania.
Yeah, Pennsylvania stinks. I'm gonna drive through
the whole state is all of it.
My god, that tank is terrifying. Jesus, those shells just flying right past your head sound, yeah, like, in my head. And if anybody's wearing headphones, like, no good, no good. They are pushing us back hard. Everybody watching the stream is like, what the hell is he looking at? I was like, if you know where to look.
God, Esper Flames says Cali produces 80% of the world's almonds. Like, that's why they account for 80% of almond sales, because they all come from California. And Mandel says California is ranked alongside whole countries for the top economies in the world. Wasn't there some, this might have been a fringe thing, but wasn't some, there's some kind of coalition of California becoming its own country and separating from the United States?
Yeah, there's, I think there's still like a, it's a fringe group, I think, but there's definitely, like, legality for that, like people trying to make that happen. I don't know how they did those rocket effects, but I mean, like, I've heard, like, I've watched videos like rockets being fired on YouTube, and like that sounds as realistic as it gets. That whoosh. I don't like it. I don't know who's shooting all those rockets. I want them to be- oh my god! That one was right past my head again. Can you imagine playing this in like VR? There's a Pavlov, which has a World War II mod that is VR. Oh, I did get that guy. That's the guy I shot earlier.
So if the California is a little nutty, then you're saying.
Jesus, somebody just ran right up on us.
I get it. In Cyphodesis, there's the Greater Idaho Movement that wants to take over Eastern Washington and Oregon and merge with Idaho.
Why was it? Because they want cheaper potatoes?
I mean, I don't know why else you'd want Idaho.
I don't either. The blue football field? I would take the state just for that.
Salty says, are there groups that want New Jersey to be an independent country? Not that I know of, but I wouldn't.
I don't think New Jersey could sustain itself.
Back when I was in middle school, I want to say there was this weird statistic that said New Jersey had like the densest population in the state, and it was because a lot of people worked in New York but actually lived in New Jersey.
So if you do that, is it a lot like Kansas City where like, so if you live on the Missouri side of Kansas City and go work on the Kansas side of Kansas City, or if you live in Kansas and then actually work in Kansas City, which is part of Missouri,
mm-hmm.
you have to pay taxes for both Kansas and Kansas City.
Yes, I think that is true because you pay income tax
right for the city
the city or the state that you work in, and then you pay like residential tax or state tax to the state that you live in.
And you know what the percentage is? There's only like 1% here, but everywhere in New York is everything's expensive out there. So
oh my god, yes, like you'll probably get paid a little more, but the rates are like much higher too. But Jersey's not significantly cheaper than New York. Like everything on the East Coast is pretty expensive. Well, not East Coast. Pennsylvania is actually a lot cheaper.
Yeah. So that's why I would just live in Albany or something like that. Like Albany's rent prices aren't crazy.
Yeah, but then there's nothing up there. Like your neighbor is a cow.
Local bars.
Full of cows. They're all drinking cow beer or whatever cows drink.
Oh no! I think that tank sees me.
I was gonna say milk, but
I got that guy.
Milk.
What a shot! Let's see if anybody goes to help him up.
And Cyclone Dab says, "Ah, finally found it. Oregon grows 99% of the U.S. hazelnut crop."
Ooh, I did not know that was coming towards me. That was scary.
I didn't know the nut business was so monopolistic. Wait, what hit you?
No, airstrike.
Because it really looked like you were just covered in the mountains. Like,
yep, I might as well have been. And maybe it was just the dirt suffocated me immediately. Did we lose all of our garrisons? How did that happen? Is that a garrison? Where's my garrison? I wish I could just spawn on my squad. Garrison, enemy near, deploy.
Autoplasmator says the monopoly on nuts is held by D's.
Tee hee. Ha ha. So what do you, I mean, you haven't seen a ton of this game yet, but what do you think?
It looks as intense as you've been making it out to be.
Yeah.
Like, it's gorgeous, for one. Like, all the effects and stuff look really cool. And yeah, like, it sounds like the coordination is key here. Like, if you're playing with, you know, a bunch of friends, or at least just people who are taking the game seriously.
Yeah.
sound like you can really get yourself an immersive shooter experience. Probably not, like, right as of right now, probably not something that I would want to spend a ton of time with.
Yeah.
But it does look like a fun time.
That dude, is it a dude that just ran over?
Okay, not going that way.
Nope.
Going back this way. I'm tired of those artilleries killing me.
You're like, is there a limit to that stuff? Like, how is the rate of them using those artillery strikes and airstrikes handled?
I don't know. I think basically to stop it, you essentially have to have a recon squad get behind enemy lines and take it out. Not mistaken.
Are there like a number of them on each map and like
no,
take out
just...
all that they have, or they can just build new ones or something?
I think there's a limited number and they're all the way back in their spawn point. I mean, there's like two ways to stop it. Like, you can go blow it up, I think, or the other part is take out the spotters if you can find them. I don't know. That being said, I don't know if they changed the mechanic to where like there's just a map functionality that you can use it on, but I don't think so.
And these things don't, like, on specific maps, they don't spawn in the same place, I would guess, right? Because otherwise you'd be like, oh, we're on this map. The artillery for the enemy would be here. Let's just launch our artillery at that.
Yeah, I'm not... not 100% on that anymore. I guess it might have changed. Like I said, I haven't played it in 5 months, and they've updated a lot. Yeah, they're just camped up on that hill. There's our recon back there. He's over there. We basically have to push forward, and they're just holding us on this hill. I'm dead again. Sniper got me. We're having a real tough time just pushing up on this, because they have that artillery zeroed in.
Yeah, they seemingly have a really good spotter.
I think I still have my garrison. Nope, let me spawn there.
Yeah, because we have to get to the run. Oh wow, we actually have a squad. Oh, that's them right there. Look at that, they're flanking right now to get to that point.
Oh. Oh, dang. You got to get up there and see how that plays out, Nick.
Yeah, it's going to take me like 10 minutes to run over there. We're trying to take out that garrison, I think, and then we have to push up. So the only thing, we just haven't had like a coordinated push yet. And I immediately died by artillery again. That's annoying.
Damn, yeah, like they're just pummeling that location.
Yep.
YouTube chat is all about Brexit right now, for some reason. Like, that's out of my wheelhouse. I don't fully understand what that was all about. I know, was it Britain voted to leave the Union, and now everyone is like, this was a bad idea?
Which they were saying from the start it was a bad idea. That one was kind of funny, because, like, Twitter and everything was fucking airstrike was very convinced that wasn't gonna happen,
and Twitch is going in on veganism, says Lampy. Well, there you go, hell has let loose in the chats.
Okay. Finally made a garrison out of that. I shouldn't immediately die from airstrike. Because apparently my whole squad was just getting wiped over and over again with that. What we need to do is flank up that hill, not go right down the middle, let's just flank.
Sora says, isn't DC trying to become the 51st state? I thought I saw that on C-SPAN, but I could be wrong. Yeah, I think that is happening. They're trying to push for that.
Yeah, I think it's going to Congress, if I'm not mistaken.
Like, it makes sense. God. They make a good argument. But also, Puerto Rico, I think, was also trying to become a state for a while, too.
I don't know. I think there's a population requirement to it.
Yeah, I don't know. I haven't looked super deep into it. I just know they were on that wait list.
Yeah.
Like, becoming a state is like getting a check mark on Twitter.
Man, we don't have an armor squad doing anything.
Nicholas B said PR voted it down at one point. That does sound familiar.
I think they lose a lot of the benefits if they become a state. I don't remember, like, a lot of the resources they get. I don't remember what happens.
I know that there's some tax reason that would be negative in regards to them becoming a state, but also, like, they...
Jesus.
They kind of get shafted in terms of, like, rights and stuff because they're not a state. So it does seem to be
that tank kind of a pro-con situation. Sitting across on the hill over there, just nailing us. Time to get out of there. Time to get out of there. Time to get out of there.
Yeah, Nicholas B says they don't get a vote in either house of Congress. Yeah, so like everyone else can make decisions about them that they have no say in, which is never really that good.
Swear to God. Stupid artillery, I hear it coming. Oh shit. Bad plane. Oh, gotcha.
But those planes are just being called in. They're aren't
that was...
flying them.
No, I'm scared because if there was one guy, that probably means there's another. God damn, you scared the shit out of me. Not doing up here by himself. Ballsy. Get me out of here, get me out of here.
I don't know what chat. Like, they're on a mean tangent, and I cannot follow how this happened.
A mean tangent? Like,
it's just so far removed from anything we were talking about. Like, they're going back and forth on the vegan thing, about industrial farming needing to keep up with vegan demands.
Oh, God, why is our artillery always targeting me? What did I do?
Probably got the highest kill count. They gotta take you out.
Jeez. I didn't ask for this.
Lampy, you know which chat. I blame you. This is probably your doing. ISIS says this game is a wee bit dull to some of us, KC. That's understandable. Nick did.
I warned that, you. It might be dull.
This would have a lot of downtime in it.
Yeah, community wanted to see it.
That is a fair criticism.
It's not dull if you're playing it because you don't know where you're getting. Oh shit, tank. Oh shit.
Vidka says they know Nick is toxic. Way. That's why they're trying to bomb you out.
Yeah. It's only one way. Only one way to take care of that. Is that guy gonna C4 that tank? Oh, is that two tanks rolling up on the. Oh, jeez. Well, we're about to lose that point.
Let's see. It actually was him that started the vegan sidebar because he said that almonds aren't vegan.
Me? I didn't start that.
No, Lampy did.
Oh.
Like, I blamed him for chat going haywire, and it actually was him, so.
So I actually pushed up. I wish my squad followed me and got out of there, because that's a death trap up there.
Isis just says, Lampy bankrolls escapists. You're not wrong.
He didn't even pay to start the vegan rant. Should be like a, if you want to take it on a tangent, should be like a toll fee. No, Tank. You don't know I'm here. Don't even act like it.
Pacific Blue with the question of the hour. Is this game any good?
I love it. The streams today haven't been that exciting. The stream today hasn't been that exciting.
Well, it honestly started off more exciting than it is now.
Oh, yeah, well, we're just getting
a lot of dead time now.
Well, not a lot of, yeah, a lot of, well, actual I'm dead time. No way, Tank. No way. No way. You don't see me. No.
And Terrence was asking, can you mark tanks?
Oh, God. Yeah, I can. They know it's coming, though. I'm just making sure it doesn't see me. That's why I'm staying here, because I made all this movement to get it here, and I really don't want it to blow me up.
I mean,
it's Well, they're about to blow it up. There's a squad behind it, about to take it out. There it goes. No more tank. Okay, time to push up. Let's go, let's go, let's go.
Nice. Lampy says, Xbox fridges for everyone.
Xbox what?
Xbox fridges for everyone.
Oh. That sounds like a bomber. That was a bomber in the woods.
Dr. Daff says, make a channel point redemption for topic tangent shift. Make it something like 100k.
100k?
Damn. I don't even have 100k.
Bankroll the escapist for a year with 100k.
Honey Money says, can I have that KFC console instead to Lampy? That thing was real, right?
Yes.
Like, and all it did was just keep your chicken warm.
I don't know. My squad's not pushing up. Look at, we're all the way up here now.
Did somebody review that console? I feel like that happened.
IGN did. I don't know. Is it out yet? I don't know if it's out yet.
That's so long ago. It has to have come out.
It was only this summer. It was only the spring that they announced it.
Like, if it was like an actual air fryer that they just called a console.
No, it's just
like,
it's just a warmer.
Still, yeah, like, because that's kind of dumb. I don't want to take up.
It sounds kind of gross, honestly.
Like, I've made chicken and now I can't eat it right away because something has come up. I need this whole KFC shaped thing in the corner to now keep that chicken the same temperature. That sounds pretty useless.
That got destroyed.
As funny as it
is. I got destroyed. How are you not shooting Gingy? He's standing in the middle of the street. How did that guy see me? Medic.
Luke wants to know, how do you get to drive a tank or do recon? Just
you have to be. No, you gotta be in the armor squad of that. So there's
armor squad.
Yeah, there's very limited, very limited amount of people that can do it. All right, I think I'm gonna try a different map just to show it because I don't need to finish this game. That map is just stalemated. Heart Lane is pretty fun. This one's fun. Hill 400 is crazy.
Wait, honey, when he says, and it's a console, the specs weren't that bad. So it's a chicken warmer and it actually does something gaming related?
Yeah, I think it's like a mini gaming PC.
That sounds dangerous.
Yeah.
Now.
I wouldn't put my food in my con. That's just weird.
Right.
Not necessary. It's unnecessary creation that goes against the laws of humanity.
Yeah. Is there like a gaming, like a snack that's good for someone who's holding a controller or a keyboard and mouse that would need to be warm? Because I feel like there aren't that many, well, if at
I,
all.
I just can't. I don't imagine warming, keeping chicken warm like that. I feel like it just gets soggy.
Well, if it's like oven like, then it would be more crispy, right? But I don't know what.
Well, it doesn't cook it. It just keeps it warm.
Yeah, it just keeps it warm. So like, what the hell is that? What does that even mean?
they want you to have tender chicken, Casey. Lots of bullets.
Eugene Crab says perhaps Nick could take the Thompson off a dead guy if you can't be an ally.
I don't remember if you can pick up people's weapons or not.
Ryan9111 suggests fried cheese sticks as like a warm gamer snack. I don't know, so if that's Cheetos. Breaded. that is awful.
I can't believe like Cheetos is the gaming snack when like, you know, your hands get all covered in that crap and
like that has to be ironic. Like that's why they're so closely tied.
Oh no.
Get away from the window.
Speaking of, he says I'm seeing a YouTuber I think that had a Hot Pocket holder attachment on their controller.
Jesus.
A Hot Pocket attachment? That's actually really freaking funny. Milky1985 says Cheetos, we call them Watsits.
What? What?
WOTSITS. Watsits.
I know it's only a matter of time until I get sniped out of that window.
MP says, I'm Googling where to get that now. I don't... I had a very short-lived love affair with Hot Pockets. Like, late college, I was like, oh, these are very snappy to eat. But very quickly, it was like, these aren't good for me. Like, they... like, these aren't good at all. So I gave them up.
Okay, we need to start making a move to Kirchhoff's. That's where we're heading next.
Luke McCree says, Cheetos, we call them Flonkin' Waffles.
Flonkin' Waffles. Okay.
I'm assuming that's a joke. That's so stupid. Oh, God. Pacific Blue says a Hot Pocket is when you're trying to hide a lit cigarette from your wife in your pocket.
What? Who hides a... Why would you hide a lit cigarette in your... I don't understand this world.
Because those are the stakes. Like, your marriage could be over, Nick, if she sees.
Oh, man. That goes.
So you take the risk of setting your pants on fire. I think you've lost control of the chats, KC. Who said I ever had control of these chats?
Bad moderator.
That's Honey Money's job.
You feed into it.
Honey Money has the most powerful wrench in the history of wrenches. So I leave it up to her. Also, Ison, you guys. You guys are responsible for this anarchy.
Shit.
Honey Money doesn't have Twitch mod status. She doesn't?
Oh, yeah. Well, Ison's over there.
Because Ison is in charge of Twitch.
One of the blueberries.
Ison says, and I'm invisible. What do you mean? I called you out. Is it because I said Honey Money first? You're upset she has top billing? I'm sorry.
Oh, yeah, I'm in. Yeah, there he is.
My mistake.
Okay. Alright, I'm moving up with my squad now. Getting out of here.
Shh, President Walker, don't let Nick know. He says $5. Because let's be real, KC, you know you enjoy the anarchy as much as we do.
How rude.
Yeah, Ison still says mod Honey Money here. They want it.
I'm in the middle of getting shot at by Americans, so
Sorry? Let him shoot you. You're a German soldier in World War II.
You're right. I'm a German soldier, not a Nazi.
Mm, thin hairs, maybe.
Ooh, that was a nasty shot. I like that.
What? Oh, shit. Cecile says, honey, money can tie a cherry stem with her tongue. Is that supposed to be part of her resume for becoming a Twitch mod? What?
You guys right on him?
Yeah, okay.
You shut it all.
Congrats.
Did he just get out of it? I think he just got out of the tank.
Do you need more than that, Casey? You know what? I guess not. You're hired.
Let me get out of the tank.
Can you do it, Casey? Says Mpogzin.
I think our squad's working on taking out this tank. Yeah.
I don't like cherries. That's gonna be my answer to that question.
Oh god. Planes are scary. A bad plane.
Oh, we're mixing in the lines right now.
Ison is asking, so is this game just US troops versus Germans?
Right now, update 10 is bringing in the Russians, and they're adding in a Battle of Stalingrad map, which looks pretty neat.
Ooh.
Why would you... No, we're not running through that field. No. Bad Piper.
Ison says I don't like chocolate chip mint ice cream either, so my tastes are suspect. I don't care what you say. Mint messes up the taste of other things it's in. You can eat mint by itself, but don't mix it with anything else. End of story. Debate finished.
Mint? You're on this again?
I think we already bring it up.
We already know you're weird. You don't need to keep making...
I can't argue with that either. I'm not. I am weird.
You mark it again. Actually, communicating.
You just got a cherry-ish. These. Oh, okay. I get what you're. I see what you were doing, President Walker. You got a cherry-ish these moments with chat.
Would a grenade do it?
Nice.
Footsteps.
Yeah, so, I mean, you guys have been watching this game for almost 2 hours now. The community's, you know, nothing bad in the chat.
Yeah, they're just making their own fun, because...
Oh, we're hunting down a guy that was hiding here a second ago.
What if he just, like, disconnected? He's like, oh no, they're onto me. And then I just left.
I'll just sit here and hide in the woods for an hour. At least we're getting stuff done over here. We took out that tank and
YouTube is obsessed with cherry puns right now.
Oh no. There's somebody out here with us. Can't find him.
Easy says cherries are too sweet and remind me of the taste of cough medicine. That's how my fiance feels about apple juice, because she spent a lot of time in hospitals when she was younger, and she would get like hospital grade apple juice, and she just associates now the taste of apple juice with like the like sickness of hospitals. So she doesn't like it.
Oh.
They're coming from behind us. What I'm pinging.
Maybe the stream really is Casey Reese chat while Nick plays a game in the background.
Yep. Yeah, it's hard to stream this game and talk at the same time. It just requires so much attention.
Yeah, you can hear your squad people talking in your ear too, right?
Oh, I think I got that guy. Did he just fall out of? What the hell happened to him? He's up there.
Oh no!
Oh, damn it! Yeah, I can't. Ever since my food poisoning a couple months ago, I can't do zucchini anymore. And I just started to enjoy zucchini.
Did the zucchini poison you?
I don't know, but this is what my body associates it with, so I cringe. Yeah, I'll have to try to get it at some point. No, I think what happened was I have a recipe for... I have a recipe for a white sauce flatbread with zucchini and all that, and I think maybe I don't know what gave me the food poisoning for sure, but that recipe, whenever I think about it, it just makes me.
But that hasn't happened to you yet for Chipotle or Taco Bell. Those are still fine.
No.
Maybe you're asking that as a joke. Today you did?
Yeah.
You're a brave man, Nick.
It doesn't hurt me that often.
This whenever you have important streams to do.
Happened twice?
That's enough. That's enough times for that same exact thing to happen. I'm being cautious.
I just have a bad relationship. Just keep going back for more. Knowing what the outcome might be.
Andrew Hickenbottom says, is a zucchini a swimwear garment made from captive animals?
Huh?
That.
Private Moin. What are you doing over here?
No words for that one. But Lampy's saying, is hospital apple juice really expensive in the U.S., Casey? I don't know if that's a joke question or a real question, but the answer is yes, because everything is expensive. In hospitals, they overcharge for everything.
Where'd that guy go? I just saw a guy run past me. I don't know where he went. I'm scared. Just going through the scary woods to find him.
Yeah, this is like a horror game. With all this
he found me. Damn it. Scared the shit out of me.
clearly.
Bang! And then he got blown up by artillery. Justice. My squad needs to put down a garrison.
Exactly that is like the abused spouse. Nick keeps going back to Chipotle, hoping things will be different.
Yes. Here we go. Assault class. Yeah, there's so much. This game's so much better when you have people to talk with.
That one guy that got me is pushing up towards the carry.
Oh, they overran our location. That sucks. How rude.
Nomi945 says, try being anti-tank.
Anti-tank? Well, I'd have to lead my squad to do that. Oh, well. Yeah, we already have an anti-tank guy. Can't be a sniper. I want to be a sniper. I'm just waiting for them to respawn that garrison. Because I don't want to. If I spawn now, I either have to spawn over here again, or I have to run a really long way. really long way. Where's this guy? Kill the guy. He's got to be in that building. Fine.
The Three Blues asking, can you be a Wendigo?
Could try.
In this game? Or just in life?
I think they're asking in this game. Alright, here we go. Hill 400. Now we gotta hold this and hopefully not lose it.
Action. Says over here we get free apple juice with our health care, Casey. Way to rub it in, Lempy. He's like, I'm thirsty. Let me just twist my ankle real quick.
Thirsty, let me twist my ankle. Feed me. You could just get really dehydrated. Go get apple juice that way. You don't have to actually hurt yourself.
Dude, you gotta sell it.
Artillery! Man, it covered like a whole quarter of the map. Oh shit, they are loading up on smoke to rush us. It's about to get intense. It's about to get really intense. I'm gonna go hide in the corner over here.
You gotta show us the action, Nick.
I'm going to. I don't want them to overrun me in the trench, though. This is a death trap. I get into a position where I'm not gonna get immediately killed. That guy just got wrecked. Where did he get wrecked from?
Andrew the Bomb says, London is getting a Wendy's soon.
Sorry.
I actually like Wendy's. It's my preferred fast food place if I'm going to have fast food.
Chick-fil-A, I mean, or Chipotle. My new favorite place is Jason's Deli.
I've not heard of Jason's Deli.
I don't know if it's local or not.
Yes. Yeah, don't really mess with Chick-fil-A, though their food is pretty good.
Chick-fil-A isn't Cane's.
Like, I've sworn off McDonald's some time ago. The last straw was when they got rid of Hi-C Orange. Like, it was such a stupid decision. It was, like, the only good thing on their menu, really. I'm like, fuck you guys. Like, just stop going altogether. And they had the nerve to bring it back, too. I'm like, no, I'm over you.
Yeah, I get... God, as soon as I turned around, I knew it. As soon as... the only time I get McDonald's is sometimes after hockey, if I just need a quick... You know, bite to eat for carbs. It's not that unhealthy.
Yeah, I mean, like, I was of the same mindset. I was like, yeah, I'll eat it every once in a while. It's not that bad.
Yeah.
Give me a high C. It's like, oh, we don't sell that anymore. It's like, what?
All right, guys, reposition to...
Like, traitors.
Like, forget this.
I'll have to.
McDonald's getting rid of Hi-C Orange was a tragedy, Casey. Keep preaching that. They brought it back. I think it's back now. But, like, the damage was done.
No, I'm not in Colorado. We have Raising Cane's in Kansas City, and they had it in Nebraska, too. It's like. The only other place I've had it is in Texas. Texas had, like, a better version of Chipotle. I forget what the name of it is now. It was like Tex-Mex Chipotle, and it was fantastic. I ordered it 3 times in 2 days. I don't know what's happening right now. Like, I don't know where they're coming from.
You gotta get up with your squad.
I'm with the whole team up here defending Hill 400, but...
Oh, then yeah, they're probably just waiting to get advanced on, like you said, right?
Yeah, well, we are. I just don't know where they're coming. I've been a while since I played this map, and I think they redid it a little bit. Because they used to have some spots.
I've heard Wendy's nuggets are good. They are.
Not good
for you. Of all the fast food nuggets, they are second probably only to Chick-fil-A.
Okay, the machine gunner there is laying prone. I hit him once. Laying a little bit further back past my body.
Lambie says, oh, so I discussed this earlier with Jesse, but next time I'm in the U.S., where should I go to get the best biscuits?
How did I not kill that guy? Hey, what?
The best biscuits in the U.S.
I get biscuits. Like,
you
cookies?
You don't get biscuits?
Or biscuits.
Oh, yeah, is that what you mean? Yeah, because you are from UK. Do you mean like bread rolls or like sugar cookies?
I'm not having a good game. Oh, is that an airstrike? Oh my goodness, that artillery is about to wreck the entire base.
There aren't too many places that I can think of in the U.S. where you just go to get, like, what we call cookies, in all honesty. But biscuits do be everywhere. American biscuits, okay. Red Lobster is number one. That's my pick. Don't care about their seafood.
Oh, their honey biscuits that they
No, the cheddar,
the cheddar biscuits. Yeah.
Yeah. Go to Red Lobster and just get the compliment. You can make them at home, but they're better at the restaurant.
No, they're not.
They are. They absolutely are.
Cheap shit at Red Lobster.
Red Lobster is a very cheap seafood restaurant, but their Cheddar Bay biscuits are amazing. Oh, he says Red Lobster is where I actually had biscuits. How did you like them? Because I think they're fantastic.
Okay, it's time for me to do something of value here.
Popeyes also does have really good biscuits. But they will dry your mouth out real fast. He said they were really good, ate more of them than the food. Exactly.
Yeah, I've done that before.
They're really good. I will absolutely fill up on Red Lobster biscuits. Popeyes has biscuits with their breakfast thing that are actually also good. Like, my fiance is obsessed with those. She'll like try to steal them from from my son's breakfast platter when he gets that. She's like, hey, can I have your biscuit?
What are they doing with that smoke? Are they gonna run up?
President Walker with a $5 donation says, Nick, you can't be insulting Red Lobster biscuits when you like Raising Cane's.
Raising Cane's like the best fast food chicken you can get.
I've never heard of or had it.
I think it's local, Midwest local at least. It's like Chick-fil-A's chicken can get kind of dry. Raising Cane's is like just super fresh every time you get it. Never had a bad Raising Cane's meal.
Honeywani's asking about a Cracker Barrel. It's a running joke in the U.S. that Cracker Barrel is extremely racist. It's not. But just the name makes it sound like it is.
People,
but
that's a thing.
Honestly, yeah, we make fun of the name. But I can't. I've eaten there like maybe two or three times. I can't remember any food from Cracker Barrel. So that food is just wholly unremarkable in my opinion.
Circle, guys. We need to get them in the circle.
Agreed. Pull back to the circle.
Oh my gosh. That's why, so I told you, like, there's a realistic force in this game, and you just don't know where anything's getting shot. You have no idea where you're getting shot.
Yeah, it looks like a straight up horror movie when you're running around in there.
Like, I know where they're coming from, but I'm just, yeah, there's so much going on.
I didn't realize the fronts on the map could be divided like that. Like, you have half of that middle section.
Yeah, sometimes there's two objectives for a front. So usually you take the southern approach to get up to the hill. I'm just trying to get out of these trenches, and that garrison's in a really bad spot.
Lampy says, so apparently I've already had the best biscuits, because he also went to Popeyes and got those biscuits too.
I like the cornbread.
From where?
Famous Dave's. I think Famous Dave's is definitely a local one.
I feel like I have heard of Famous Dave's, but I can't really pinpoint where.
I am terrified of people running up through that smoke.
Pacific Blue says, I want to spend my life savings on the deep sea mission to capture one of the behemoth deep sea crabs with legs the size of a car so that I can devour it with a bucket of butter.
A bucket of butter. Hell yeah. Oh boy, I'm about to die.
The very specific dream, Pacific Blue, but I hope you can make that happen one day.
I didn't die. I gotta kill.
Talk about sweet tea. Are you a fan of sweet tea, Nick?
No.
Yeah, I don't like it.
There's some sweet teas I'll do. Like, I like raspberry iced tea.
What's weird about sweet tea is that it tastes like there isn't any sugar in it.
Yeah.
And that's what confuses people when I say, I want iced tea. They're like, oh, sweet tea? I'm like, yes, the iced tea that has sugar in it. And then they bring me sweet tea, which decidedly does not taste like a Nestle iced tea or something. And I'm very upset about it.
Ooh, I just nailed that guy in the head too. It's not gonna last forever, but I've gotten 3 kills just hiding out here.
Damn. Anyone, he says, Casey, do you know about the heart attack grill? About the heart attack grill. If you don't finish your meal, you get spanked.
Oh yeah, I've heard about that. Another kill. That's 4.
I've not heard of that. Not all that interested in getting spanked by whoever runs the heart attack grill.
And I died.
That was a nice little run, though.
Yep, I got 4 kills. I finally found a spot. That's how you defend Hill. You just hide and hope you don't die. I have to let go.
And when he says, yeah, they hit you hard, too. Oh, no. Have you gone? Have you experienced this, Honey Money?
I've been hit with a belt at a strip club once. That wasn't fun.
Like, were they trying to be kinky, or like, did you do something wrong?
No, it was for my fraternity initiation. They paid the girl to take a belt and smack me with it. They were like, it's not hazing because we didn't do it. Oh, bot. There was one guy.
Maybe asking, was it the bouncer, Nick?
Nope. But there was one guy at the strip club. That they were whipping him with the belt so much he started crying. It was pretty funny. His friends just kept paying for it. They told you not to touch. Yeah, no. Nope. That was I've only been to strip clubs twice, and both times I'm like, this ain't for me. It's just weird. Especially I wasn't old enough to drink yet, so I couldn't be drunk at the strip club. Had no idea they were that interactive with their patrons. Like, you know, I knew the back room stuff. I didn't know like out in the main room they would take your belt and whip you with it.
Like, what the hell? I don't like that. I don't like people hitting me. Like, cut it out. I just want to eat dinner.
Just want to eat dinner. The scooter's for you. Don't think they can hit you with a belt there. It's actually a restaurant I've never been to.
Yeah, I've had like events at.
Heard their chicken wings are pretty good, but that's about it.
Yeah, they have decent wings.
Maybe I will DoorDash it.
Anyone says, don't they often joke that strip clubs have a good buffet? I wouldn't know. You know what? I've only ever been in a single strip club. It was while I was visiting New Orleans, and we immediately left because they were like, hey, to sit in here, you gotta buy this number of drinks and such. And I was like, well, I'm not gonna drink anything. Can I like buy
going to a
like
strip
a
club
juice?
And not drink? What kind of madman are you?
He was like, we only sell alcohol here. So I was like, all right, I'm leaving.
We don't even offer water.
You're like, they were lying. They were like, just buy something to drink. I was like, no, you can't force me to do what I don't want to do.
This isn't a place for peer pressure, KC. No peer pressure.
So that's my entire strip club experience.
This was a bad idea. This is the worst. Oh, I threw it through the window. Bad. Somebody's gonna shoot a rocket here. It's gonna end my day. And that's how KC got spanked by the bouncer for not drinking. I think that's fair. I'm scared. If this was real war, I'd be doing the same thing.
Yeah, fast food restaurant that they know in strip club that is said to have the best steak in the whole state. The owner also owns a beef ranch or something.
Don't go that way. Don't go that way.
I knew it. I knew it. As soon as I walked that way, I was dead. Yeah, I've never been to a strip club that actually served food.
Yeah, I wasn't in that one long enough to know if they did sell food.
Yeah, and I don't think I'd eat at a strip club either.
Yeah, it doesn't sound like it goes well together.
Yeah. Doesn't sound very appetizing to eat around that. If I was in the smoke, I'd throw a grenade into the little hut. Yep, that's what I was waiting for.
Milky 1985 says, I don't think the strippers make the food.
Yeah.
While that is hilarious, pretty sure that's beside the point. Yeah, the point is, like, if people are being, like, naked or half naked, you want to separate that from food. Like, period.
Yeah, this seems like a fair thing to say.
Right, like it's just.
I don't want glitter in my food. Thank you.
Milky 1985 says, "What about whipped cream?" Me, myself, personally, still don't like that. I don't like mixing actual edible stuff with anything of that nature. Like, it's messy. Andrew Glenn says, yeah, I've always found those things in movies where they serve sushi on a nudie lady. Kind of gross. I mean, isn't sushi meant to be super clean and pure? Maybe, but yeah, like I don't want to eat off of skin.
You don't want to eat skin. You don't want to eat skin.
Like off of skin, like skin as a plate.
You don't want to use skin as a plate.
No, it's,
are you cannibal?
It's more so if it's if it's in a strip club where like everyone's a stranger, like that's also like more of a step removed. But also. I don't like the idea of like sticky food on me or another person. Yeah. Like that just strikes me as dirty, not sexy.
Oh man, they're pushing hard.
Oh fuck. God.
I think I have more kills this game than I did the first game.
Probably, yeah, you were on that little hill for a while.
Yeah, I just got two
taking
more.
Taking folks out.
Spam on pizza, help me. That's his name. He's a medic.
I'm no longer hungry. Rip my appetite.
Oh god, ban President Walker. Yeah, if you guys like this chat, then you're gonna like the new podcast we just recorded today.
Oh yeah. It's pretty much just this.
We went in some weird topics today. Take a shot for every death. Yeah, that's this entire game. You die, you hope to live for more than 5 minutes. I just can't believe we've held Hill 400 this long. Like, we've been getting attacked nonstop. our team, like, as much as it doesn't look like much is going on in this game, the fact that this team has held Hill 400 this long is pretty impressive. Because usually it's just a constant back and forth of losing hill, retake hill, losing hill, retake hill. There's only 5 minutes left in this match, so we're still. If as long as we hold this, we win.
Like they're attacking from like multiple sides.
Yeah, they're attacking everywhere, and they're coordinating. That commander on that team is having them flip the directions that they're taking us from. That sounded bad, but you know what I mean. I don't think, like, they, jeez,
parking spot for Junior says it sounds more like Hill Let Loose.
Hill Let Loose, yeah.
Ah.
Yeah, this is this.
See what he did? See what I did there?
This is one of those maps that's really slow. Like you either push or you don't. Like, because basically to move forward, you would have to take the southern approach, and then go take Kirchweg, and then you have to flank to get the other one. But they changed this map a lot. It used to just be a straight line from Hill 400 to the other points. And if you controlled Hill 400, then you're basically moving off the hill, taking the next point, and keep pushing.
They're coming towards that bunker that I'm pinging. That's where they're pushing up too fast.
But yeah, but
now they're all on hill puns.
Darren has infected culture. He's being removed.
Darren's puns will save us as a country.
Yeah,
bring us all back together again.
The right wingers, all they need is the puns, and they'll be happy again.
Cypher Dash is back to the strippers.
Yeah. I don't even know what's happening. Okay.
Nick.
I got one.
Montalbano in the chat says Nick recognized Nick.
Yes.
That's the official Nick. Call out.
Oh shit, we lost the hill. How the hell did that happen? Push.
Excuse me, Nick. Some of us were punters before we met Darren.
Oh, well, I got one. It wasn't me. Oh, they were just hiding out in there. There's a bunch in there. There's just a tossy grenade right there.
Blue version again brings up the fact that my mic looks like a drink can. I think you guys are just thirsty.
Yeah, if they keep talking about strippers, they're obviously thirsty.
They're all kinds of thirsty today.
My teammate killed me. How rude, Jay.
Dang, that's war. Sometimes it happens.
Ooh, hey, there's a recon squad available. No, it's locked. How rude.
President Walker says, ooh, you got nicked by that bullet.
Can I get somebody to go support?
Teehee.
I could do that.
Because your name is Nick.
Nice. Oh, I didn't know that.
That's where he's going with that one. It looks like a Pepsi can without the logo. I don't think this is that shiny. I mean, there's my light is behind this, so like that gleam is maybe making it look a lot more metallic than it is.
Your microphone?
Yeah, like the Blue Yeti here, they're saying it's just very.
No.
It's a soda can.
There's no way they're pushing down this way already. There's only.
Wasn't that the first telephone, though? Like two Pepsi cans?
Oh, man.
Connected
we,
by string.
We were so close to winning that. There was only like 4 minutes left, and they managed to take it back.
Damn.
Now we gotta push. Oh, my God. We gotta push up the hill and take it back.
Mike Below wants to know, just curious, how much whiskey is too much whiskey? Nick, you're the resident drinker.
When you start seeing spots.
Wait, what do you want us to spawn at?
God, I just saw him. I knew it.
So basically just my life?
Okay. I'm done with this game for today. It's 5 o'clock anyway. I gotta make dinner, and I gotta go get ready for hockey. If I can go. I still have a headache. I cold turkey and Mountain Dew, so... not feeling great.
No, you should be feeling much better.
Yeah, eventually.
You got the shakes right now?
No, I just get the caffeine and lack of sugar headache. It's probably not best to cold turkey that stuff, but I was like, you know what? I want to get back in the gym. I want to get off of it right now. I just want to be done. No more. Let me get back on coffee. All right. I think that's it for today. Let's see, tomorrow's Tuesday. You're streaming. It's probably throwback because I don't think you reviewed anything lately.
Yeah, if we're not going to do the Ender Lilies,
Oh yeah, you can do that.
You can totally do throwback. No, you want to do anything. Okay, yeah, I can do that too. It's fine.
And then Wednesday's Ratchet & Clank Rift Apart, which I may be there for. I'm not sure. Other than that, Thursday is today. We try. It's Jack's day, so I'm sure he'll play something weird. And then Amy's back on Friday for something, and on Saturday's game night. I don't think we've decided what we're playing yet, but we'll probably do something fun for that, obviously. So
that's not going to be the first of the community things.
Is this Friday? Yeah, I guess we can do golf with your friends this Friday. We'll do that. We'll do golf with your friends on Saturday. Yep. So make sure you buy that if you haven't yet. If you want to play, I'll be looking out for B-Pen Dragon, my nemesis, and then. We'll see everybody tomorrow.
Bye, guys. Take it easy.
He's checking to play the yogurt game. He played that last week. Now, bye.